one vertical, one horizontal, overlapping. Yeah? Does this bring back memories?
Yeah.
Good. Mm-hmm. Okay, then you're going to make like a kite shape. So you're going to fold this in. Okay? And if you think of the line they're running, it's about the same position here. Now don't worry if you've got this little bit, because we can bring that in a second. Okay, like that. To stop it from moving, you can just put a little bit of tape there. Okay, in this bit you can put a little bit of tape there also, just to stop it from moving. Now that will be your background for your design, but we don't want our customers to see our tape, so we're now going to turn that way around. So you've got a bit of a cleaner finish. Your design then sits not above the cellophane, because the cellophane's there to protect it. It sits just where your tissue paper is, and showing a bit of the tissue paper background. This here is your binding point, so that's going to cover that round, okay? And what you're going to do here, what you don't want to start doing, what you should remember last time, is doing it really tight like that, yeah? You've got this beautiful shape of your design. Because you've got nice spiralling, you're going to have to work around that. Hold where the tape is, where your binding point is. Now for today, we're not going to cut the stems too short. I've just trimmed them, so it might look a bit long, but it's because we're just practicing. Again, where the tape is, the binding point. I'm going to try and meet that there. So that collar's round. Okay, so you've got the cellophane trying so it meets. And then you could put a little bit of tape just to hold it in place. But I like to tie with a bit of ribbon. Now you can put sellotape, but sometimes when you do sellotape it becomes quite bulky and not as right where that point is, because you can actually lose marks in the assessment if that isn't tied in the same place. So I like to tie it with some ribbon just to keep it secure. And usually it's the same colour as what my bow's going to end up like. It makes it nice and firm. The finish, when we do eventually cut the stems, I'll show you, we make like a separate bag, but for today, you've still got it there. You could cut this off or even fold it up. Just put a bit of tape in the back, just to stop it from forming. And then you would make a bow. It could be a pom-pom bow, figure of eight bow, whatever you want. I'm going to do a figure of eight. Showed you. So stop like this. Remember, you hold it with your finger and your thumb. Visualize that number eight, over, under, where your fingers are here. Place it in. Over. Place it in. Two or three each side. And once you've done that, we're going to cut off, tie that round. Got to be quick now with this bit, this is where you get your fingers nice and tight. And then you can either thin it out, remember last week we were thinning them out, and you can leave it as it is. And then where the binding point is here, that's where you're going to tie your bow. So it finishes. And remember what we were saying last week, don't do that because you're going to damage your roses. So try and cross it if you can and tie it at the front. Now, very traditional design used around the periods in floristry. When would you see it?
Valentine's.
Valentine's, yes. How much do you think something like this could be sold for?
20.
Oh, you're a very cheap florist. Anyone else? Personally, how much would you sell in your shop?
That's at least 50.
How much would David pay for it?
35?
35? Ooh. I would say an average bouquet around Valentine's Day for 12 roses, now bear in mind we haven't got 12, is about £65.
Really?
Yeah?
Can you repeat that?
Yeah, 2 days later it's probably half.
It is, yeah, you're right, yeah, you're true. Because it's Valentine's, the prices will double or even treble than you would buy usually. Because they're red, they go up, like Mother's Day. Because they're pink, they'll be more expensive than maybe orange, because pink's associated with Mother's Day. Christmas colours as well will reflect in the price. But usually, around that sort of price is what it would be. You're in shock, Shine, aren't you? 65. So the thing to remember is why is the binding point important to be firm and tight?
Because
men always walk down the road like this.
Yes.
No, and women do as well. And normally, as I say, from experience, I've had a trail of flowers down the road where this customer's walked down the road and it's not tied in. So that's really important, that it's tied in, all secure. And we will do that in assessment. We'll make sure it's all secure. Even the bits of levelling, yeah? Mm-hmm. What was that called?
Profile.
Good, good. This area here where I've tied it?
Binding.
Excellent. Okay, so I'll come round and help you. Off you go. Let's give you about 10 minutes.